6 months, which may be only today and then during the prayer sessions. There are other vessels that God will use to speak. Amen. And those walls will be established.
Yeah.
Are you in Zechariah chapter 1?
Yes, sir.
I read verses 18 to 21 again. Then I raised up my eyes and looked, and there were four horns. And I said to the angel that talked with me, "What are these?" So he answered me, "These are the horns that have scattered Judah, Israel, and Jerusalem." Then he showed me, thank God for verse 20, because if he had ended in verse 19, then we are done for. That means there's no defense. They have come to scatter us, and there's nothing we can do. But he continued, he showed me, may God show you this
way,
four craftsmen. And I said, what are these coming to do? So he said, these are the arms that scattered Judah. Yes, you told me that before. So that no one will lift up his head. Every situation that wants to make your head bow down. Everything that is making you to be behind your peers. An end has come to them. Everything that is mocking your Christianity. You come to church from January, it looks as if there's no God. It's a new day for you.
Yeah.
I'm saying for somebody here, it's a new day.
Yeah.
Those days of shame and reproach, crying in your bedroom closet, crying in your... Many of you have cried by the Spirit of God. I know quite a number of us have been shedding tears from January. Lord, don't forget me. Lord, have mercy. Lord, when shall it be my turn? Your turn is now.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Your days of rejoicing are here.
Amen.
Your jubilee is here.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Because Christ is our jubilee.
Yes,
so he's here. Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. He says, so that no one will lift up his head. But the craftsmen are coming, and thank God they are here.
Amen.
To terrify them.
Amen.
To cast out the horns of the nations that lifted up their horns against God's chosen people. Talking about you. So where would that take us, Pastor? Come with me to Ezekiel. Because in this house, the voices of many have risen up to God. Many have said, Lord has forgotten me. Many have said, I am frustrated and I'm weary. I can't even do anything anymore. I've prayed, I have fasted. Nothing has changed. For people like that, let's see what the word of God. Ezekiel 37. I'll read quickly from verses 1 to 14. The hand of the Lord came upon Pastor Adeyemi and brought me out in the spirit of the Lord. Thank God for the Holy Ghost. Set me down in the midst of the valley, and it was full of bones. Then he caused me to pass by them all around. And behold, there were very many in the open valley. And indeed, they were very dry. Then he said to me, God showed them the problem, the hopeless situations, the circumstances beyond man's ability to fix. God showed them. Many of you, the situation looks hopeless, looks helpless. Some have even given up. Somebody here has said, this is my cross. It's not your cross. Your cross is breakthrough.
Amen.
Your cross is breaking forth.
Amen.
Your cross is joy and celebration.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Then he said to me, verse 3, son of man, can these bones live? So I answered, O Lord God, only you know. Again he said to me, amazingly, God didn't speak to the situation. He told a man to speak. And you are that man that will speak to that situation. Many times we are calling upon God to speak, and God is waiting upon us to speak. God told one of his servants, said, my people can have what they say. But he said, my people are saying what they have. There are two different things. God said, you can have what you say. But many are saying what they have. They are declaring, oh, they have not given me. I don't know whether they will give me. I'm not even sure. You know, if somebody can just die anyhow. You never know what God will do. And God is saying, you can say, I will not die, but live, and he will sanction it, he will approve it. But people are saying, you never know what God will do. You know, some people came to Canada, they were just deported. Maybe it's not my place to come here. If it's not your place to be here, God will never allow you to be here. Because he opened the door to you. He has approved your stay here. Do away with those negative thoughts. Or didn't you read Psalm 91? Though 1,000. May go down on your side. And 10,000 more on your right hand side. Does that mean you are supposed to go down? So you don't judge the multitude with your case. Somebody here is saying, my case is different. Until you see that your case is different, you will align your case with those who are going down. God is saying, even 11,000 are going down by the numbers. You are exempted. I said, you will see it. You will not experience it. And the one that said that, does he have the ability to do it?
Yes, sir.
Or is just making mouth?
No.
He's the creator of heaven and earth.
Yes, sir.
He's the one that spoke and have it done. He's the one that purposed and is still standing.
Yes, sir.
That is the one that has spoken that brought you to this nation.
Yes, sir.
And he said in Amos 9:15, I will plant them in their whole land, and they shall no more be uprooted.
Yes.
Okay? Did he say immigration officer can approach anybody?
No.
I don't care if they have written your deportation order. If you believe God, that means if you believe the word of God, that deportation order shall become welcome to Canada.
Yeah.
That red bank account shall become so green and so black that it will be a channel of blessing to us.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Let's keep reading. This month you are going somewhere.
Amen.
He said, son of man, verse 4, prophesy to these dry, hopeless bones. If it's some of us, we will tell God, God, there's no need to speak to these ones. They are so dry. Can we just close this chapter and do something else? These ones are dry. Look at this one, so dry. In fact, if some of us have been there in Genesis chapter 1 with God, when there was darkness, voidness, and shapelessness, and God said, light, he said, can't you see it's dark? We will talk God out of calling light because we are so conversant, we want to tell it as it is. We want to tell God, I can't. There is darkness. Don't call it as light. Amen.
Amen.
But until you call it, it can't happen. No. If God can't change darkness without opening his mouth, you can't change your situation with a closed mouth. It's an impossible. You can't do it. But for everyone that would dare open their mouth, whatever you call your situation, like Adam called them, so it shall be.
Amen.
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 He said, prophesy to these bones and say something to them. Oh, bones, you are so dry and you are scattered. I don't even know where you belong. Is that what he's supposed to say? Because that's what some people are saying. Pastor, I want to make you understand my situation. It's so grave. The devil took me yesterday and whacked me. Ah! If not for the mercy of God, he panel beat my side here. He moved here again. You are just glorifying the devil. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
In other words, it doesn't matter how low the devil has brought you, he will be put under your feet.
Amen.
With the word of God in your mouth.
Amen.
So the man did what? He said, hear the word of God. Thus says the Lord to these dry situations. Surely I will cause breath to enter into you, and you shall be. And I see that prayer card shall be delivered.
Yeah.
I see that one that is lacking today become a supplier of rest.
Yeah.
I see that pain in the body leaving.
Yeah.
I see that closed wound opening up.
Yeah.
I see that one that has been desiring his mate and her mate. I see them becoming two, becoming one.
Yeah.
I see that one that job that has looked that looks as if it's not gonna come. I see them calling you this way. He said, I will put sinews on you and I will bring flesh upon you. I will cover you with skin and I will put breath into you. And you, can you see Ezekiel speaking to dry bones, talking and pointing his finger? You shall live. It looks like a crazy act. But let's see whether it worked. Because if it worked for him, and you act on the same word of God, it must work for you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
But if it didn't work for him, then we don't have any basis to expect an answer. So let's see. Verse 7. Let's go to 7. So I prophesied as I was commanded. And as I prophesied, there was a noise. In my Bible, I underline the noise. Because in your life, there will be noise.
Amen.
Nothing changes without noise. And that noise may come from around you, very close to you. And there was a rattling. A rattling means a shaking. Things began to rattle. And the bones began to come together. Bone to bone. Indeed, as I looked, the sinews and the flesh came upon them. And the skin covered them. But there was no life in them. And he said to me, that means your speaking has not ended. He said, prophesy to the breath. This time around, he told him to speak to the atmosphere. He said, speak to the wind. The word for breath is the word for wind. It's also the word for spirit. That's why the Holy Spirit is like a wind. That's why the Bible said God rides upon the wings of the wind. Amen.
Amen.
Say, speak to the winds, prophesy, son of man, and say to the breath, thus says the Lord God, come from the forward, from winds. That means the one that set up this universe has four directions that winds can come from. In other words, he said, speak to the north. In my spirit, I saw the man of God, Ezekiel, speaking, oh breath, come from the north, come from the south. Where is east and west? Which one is this? Okay, whatever you call it. He spoke to it and he turned. Amen. And you will do that. Why, if it's not important, it will not tell him to speak. Because there is something that has been loaded into those four compass regions that are meant for you. Amen.
Amen.
So I prophesied as he commanded me, and breath came into them, and they lived. Your situation will live.
Amen.
That breakthrough will live.
Amen.
That testimony. testimony shall be sure.
Amen.
And they stood upon their feet, and exceedingly great army. Then he said to me, Son of man, these bones are the whole house of Israel. This time around, he's in chapel. They indeed say, our bones are dry, our hope is lost, and we ourselves, God has cut us off. You know what I did 2 years ago? I'm suffering the punishment of what I did. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Behold, my people, I'm in verse 12 now. I will open your graves. I will cause you to come up from your graves. I will bring you into the land of Canaan.
Amen.
Not only you are already there, so I will plant you in the land of Canaan.
Amen.
In my Bible, I wrote Amos 9:15. Because every time I read this, it takes me back to Amos. I am already in the land. I only need to be planted. And the Bible says, planted in the house of the Lord, they will what? They will prosper. So what I'm waiting for is the grace to prosper. Where he has planted me, he uprooted me from Nigeria, took me to America. He said, I thought it was there. I said, no, that's not where you are going. You are meant for Canada.
Yeah.
Because your prospering is here, and I am there, and you are there.
Amen.
So you will go up this month.
Yeah.
Doesn't matter if everybody in Canada goes down, they will not go down, but even if they go down, you will be standing upright.
Yeah.
Because you are the planting of the Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Then you shall know that I am the Lord. When I have opened your graves, O my people, and brought you up from your graves, I will put my spirit in you, and you shall live. I thought somebody would say amen. And I will bless you in your own land. I will bless you in your own land. That goes even beyond the physical land. Is your land business endeavor? Is your land to be, is it your land to be a medical doctor? This applies to your sphere of calling. Are you meant to be an accountant? Is your land to be a lawyer? Whatever he has called you to be in this nation, you are becoming it. He said it. I'm just echoing what he said.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Then you shall know that I, the Lord, I have spoken it, and I have also performed it, says the Lord.
Amen.
Father, thank you. Reka to Cobra, this. These were spiritual experiences with physical manifestations. These two scriptures we read. Prophet Ezekiel. Those spiritual experiences were not for them as persons, passive. They are for God's people. And if there is anybody that we can call God's person, there can't be any God person more than you.
Yes, sir.
Because we are the body of Christ.
Yes, sir.
We are part of the Godhead. We are part of the Godhead. There will never be another group of people like the church. There has never been like the church. Because our head is Jesus. But the head cannot live alone. Oh, is there one head sitting beside you there without body? Amen.
Amen.
If there is a head be sitting beside you without body, I know you won't be sitting down and smiling like that. You will have changed role. Amen.
Amen.
So every time you hear Christ, think of a union. You and Christ. Whatever applies to Christ, applies to you.
Amen.
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 In Zechariah, the one in Zechariah 1:18-21, the horns represent powers, represent authorities, the deployment of the forces of hell to dislodge you from your place of blessing, to make your head to be bowed down, to make you not to be able to stand at par with your equals. Amen.
Amen.
those were not the plantings of God. They were not God's plan for them, as they are not His plan for you. The Bible said, while men slept, the enemy came and planted us. Amen.
Yeah.
That delay is not from God. That sickness is not of God. That immigration rejection is not from God. It didn't bring you to Canada to humiliate you. Redemption beautifies. Redemption doesn't put shame on people. It rolls away shame. It gives a better future. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
They represent satanic, oppressive, and suppressive powers. Contrary to God's people, they are suppressed. They are forces that suppress. They are forces that oppress. They are two different things, but they are demonically controlled. But their reign against you is over.
Yeah.
Wherever the remote control is, the thunder of the Holy Ghost shall shatter it.
Yeah.
Wherever they are buried, you see, some they are buried in the depth of the sea. Some are buried under rocks. Some are buried under iroko trees. If you know what iroko trees are. Wherever they have buried your tomorrow, wherever they have buried your dreams, I stand in the place of Christ to announce a destruction coming to those images they have carved of you, those words they've spoken against you. I step back to center. I take those things with another word from the throne of heaven today in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. In the second one, in the second part, talk about the craftsmen, the carpenters. They are ministering angels of God, assigned or deployed by your Father, with Jesus our commander in chief, for your deliverance. Said the carpenters have come to hammer their head. Everything that is contrary to you, I see a hammer in the hand of the one that sits upon the white horse, the one that is covered with rope deep in blood. I see him hammering those situations to hell in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Because they are here. Where we are, may I announce to you that we are not by ourselves here.
Oh.
I sense ministering angels all around this place. Just like they showed up in the time of the man of God, Elijah. The Bible said the enemy surrounded him with chariots. And his servant thought there was no way out. Because physically he could see the situation. But the man of God just laughed and told him, they that be with us, they are more. And Gehazi's servant looked at him. 1, 2. He was trying to do the mathematics. 1, 2. With all this, 1. Oga, I don't think your mathematics is right. And the man of God said, you don't know. There are a lot of things you don't know. He said, Lord, open his eyes that he may see. And God granted that request so that we can learn from it.
Amen.
That even though there are chariots of the enemy that surrounded them, but they are finite numbers. And God opened his eyes and he saw chariots of fire.
Yes.
Too numerous to be counted, surrounding the enemy.
Amen.
And the enemy didn't know that they are already surrounded. When he saw that, I saw him put his hand in his pocket and said, my master, my master. But the question is, when did those chariots of fire, when did they get there? They mean, your protection is sure, guaranteed before. You don't need to see them physically. That's why I said this place is surrounded by the angels of God. And everything that is contrary to you is not living here with you.
Yeah.
It's not, they are not living here with you.
Yeah.
Because they are not here to be spectators. Those angels are here to carry out an assignment.
Amen.
And the assignment is already started.
Amen.
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 So rejoice, people of God.
Yeah.
For I have come in your midst to manifest myself. I have come to demonstrate my glory in your midst. Those that trust me as their mighty Savior, those that call upon me as their deliverer, my mighty hand is extended to them. And this month they shall rejoice. Send the Spirit of the living God.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Here in the Son of the Bush. Megra do Sandala Bush. Karabasandala Bush. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
In Ezekiel 37, you know I said that by the Spirit of God?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Just want you to know. Ezekiel 37, they said, verse 1 said, the hand of the Lord was upon me. Amen.
Amen.
The hand of the Lord represents the anointing of God. It represents the person of God. It represents no other than the Holy Ghost. It represents divine intervention. That's where we are going this month. That same hand, they saw it in Egypt. Because Moses threw down the rod of God, it became a serpent. And Pharaoh called his magicians, his enchanters, the forces of this of the enemy. They threw down their own rods and they became serpents. But there was something that happened that will happen to you this month. The Bible said the serpent of Moses began to pick up all those serpents one by one. Chuck up, chuck up, chuck up, chuck up, chuck up. And swallow them. The Bible did not tell us how many, but it swallowed them up. Everything that is contrary to you. The serpent of God, the one that was lifted on high. Because God told Moses, make a brazen serpent. Lift it up on the pole. Jesus Christ is the serpent. He will swallow up everything that is contrary to you. In fact, by God, I said to somebody, they are swallowed up on it.
Hallelujah.
The dry bones represent, excuse me, many challenges. They represent limitations, barriers, difficult to bear situations. Those heavy weights that some have carried since they landed in this country, either they came in, whichever way they came, you have carried that burden long enough. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The one that's able to shoulder it is stepping in.
Yeah.
The open valley is a type of the low points of life. For many of you, your mates back home, they are sending you pictures of their new house they just built. And you are still in shelter here. And you are saying, can my situation ever change? Did I not make a mistake coming here? Amen.
Amen.
I have good news for you. The hand of God is going to carry you beyond what they have accomplished. You didn't hear me? Divine speed is being granted to you. So the question this afternoon, or this month, as we begin to build on it this month, the question is, how strong is your faith? In whom do you trust? It is the evaluation of our faith and the depth of our understanding of God's power. Because for some of us, the devil and God, they are on the same level. And maybe God will just manage to give me the victory. The Bible says he sees far above. How far? As far as far can be. The same word that was used there was used in Psalm 103. He said, as the east is far from the west. The same word. How far is the east from the west? Science is yet to calculate it. And the Bible said that is how far he seated above principalities, powers, rulers, and wicked spirits in the heavens. They are no match for your God. That means they are no match for you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Can you begin to see yourself in Christ? Amen.
Amen.
Because how you see yourself will determine how you will speak. It will determine what you will bow down for. They told the three Hebrew boys, he said, bow down or you will burn. But because they saw the God of Israel, they refused to bow. And they did not burn. Because they saw God. How? They saw God in his commandment. Thou shalt worship no other God, nor bow before them, except for me. And they said, no. No, we will not. We are not even careful to answer you. In other words, do your worst. How can you speak to the one that can kill you? And you said, do your worst. If you don't have something that you are trusting in, that you know is greater than a person. Now, where it came from, a few years ago, they said, if a dog has a very strong backer, he will challenge something.
Yes,
sir. You get it? Ordinarily, the dog is no match for what the dog is challenging. But there is somebody that is saying, go ahead, I'm here. And as long as that thing or that person is there, it can swing anyhow. That is the same picture that David saw that made him to run towards Goliath.
Yes, sir.
He said, who is this uncircumcised Philistine that is speaking trash against the army of the Lord? He said, today your head is coming down, and for somebody, the head of your Goliath is on the floor. Now your Goliath could be anything. But if you see your God above that Goliath, you will not act like Saul that was hiding. You will act like David that talked big and ran towards the problem. Because the solution is in you.
Yes, sir.
It's in your mouth. It's where?
In my mouth.
What did God tell us? Life and death. They are in the what? That word power is the word hand in the hand of. That means life, your tomorrow is in your hand. You control your tomorrow. Not the enemy. Not the devil. The devil is irrelevant in your tomorrow. In your stay in this nation, the devil has no say.
Yes, sir.
Unless you hand it over to him. I have made a decision. The devil will not control my tomorrow. I and my God, we will decide, and we already made a decision. My tomorrow is sure. My tomorrow is good. My tomorrow is wonderful. I am a testimony that is happening. That is my choice. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Are you getting anything?
Yes, sir.
I have to close somewhere. In other words, the Bible said there was a noise that erupted. Let me touch on this. As the man spoke, that is a graphic representation of things getting loosed from the forces that have been holding them down. The man that has refused to treat that immigration fire, there is going to be a noise. There is going to be a shaking. The one that sits on top of the world, the one crushing their head. I see him removing their chairs and bringing another chair that will favor you. I see God touching your body right where you sit. Your situation coming together.
Amen.
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 I said what? Amen. My situation. We are coming together. What did I say again?
My situation.
Only people on this side are saying.
My situation. Is coming together.
Because your mouth said it, it is done.
Amen.
Pastor, I think we're just making us see all these things. We're just trying to build up our hope. Without hope, your faith has nothing to work on. And God has sent me to touch upon those hopeless situations. The Bible spoke about Abraham, said, who against hope believed in hope. What does that mean? That means there was no natural evidence for him to have hope. So he went to the Word of God to get hope. Like I'm painting hope for you from the same Word of God. He is body 99-year-old man. 90-year-old woman. Has it ever happened? Which news carried it? CNN, CP24, CBC, CIBC, or which one? Or any none ever carried it except the Word of God. That's where you are getting your news from now.
Amen.
I'd rather get my news from here. Because the news out there will tell you what has happened.
Yes.
This one will tell you what is going to happen.
Yes, sir.
And for somebody, there is a rewriting of the story.
Yes.
There is a new day.
Yes.
He said the carpenters are here to scatter those horses.
Yes.
He said, you may think the situation is beyond redemption. God is, as said, I am alive.
Yeah.
I am the God of the living, not the God of the dead.
Yeah.
Revelations 1:18. I was alive. I was the one that was dead. I'm alive and I shall be alive forever. I'm the God of Abraham and Isaac. He didn't say I was. Your God is beyond time. Time has no constraint on him. So how long that situation has been there is irrelevant to God, because today is your day of breakthrough.
Yeah.
Today is your day of miracle.
Yeah.
In the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
Lastly, the graves represent things that are buried, things that are forgotten, things that are abandoned, visions, ideas, destinies, relationships, and expectations. By now, you expected that you have your own house. By now, you expected that you'll be carrying your own babies. And it looks as if every day you are moving farther than that dream, than that expectation. God has sent me to announce to you that the graves are open.
Yeah.
The carpenters are here.
Yeah.
The miracle worker is in your house.
Yeah.
You will carry your own babies.
Yeah.
You will live in your own houses.
Yeah.
That car, I see you holding the key of that car. Is speaking on it. In this nation of Canada, no force shall be able to uproot anyone.
Amen.
He sent me as an appointed and ordained servant of Jesus. I have bowed my knees to no other Lord except Him. Amen.
Yeah.
I have not sought power from any other God. So I stand above them today.
Amen.
And I address the one that is called the spirit of death and loss.
Amen.
I address you